Aryan Khan is prima facie, they think that is a person who is involved in the whole drug conspiracy. He was called there, and on the basis of that, the others were called for this particular rave party, as has been claimed by the Narcotics Control Bureau. They have also given the whole summary of the dates, that how one after the other, during the investigation, during the interrogation of various accused persons, different teams came forward, and on the basis of that, they have arrested various people. There is a specific mention of the conspiracy as well in the affidavit filed by the Narcotics Control Bureau in this particular case. If I may read from the affidavit, he clearly mentions that even though from some accused person there is no recovery, he is mentioning about Aryan Khan. Look at what NCB says in the affidavit. Even though there is no recovery or recovery of a small quantity, because there was an allegation, normally as per the NDPS Act, if the recovery is not of the commercial quantity, it's a bailable offence. If it is not a commercial quantity, that means the person is not involved in selling of the drugs, or business of the drugs. So that means he has purchased the drugs to consume for himself or whoever the person is. So basically, the affidavit reads that though some of the accused persons, there is no recovery of a small quantity of a contraband, the participation of the act and the omission of such persons who have acted in concert, conspiracy in the commission of offence form the basis of this investigation. That means they say ki even if they have found nothing against him, that does not mean that he was not part of the conspiracy, is what the NCB officials have filed as an affidavit in the case. And specific, as far as Aryan Khan is concerned, they say that accused number 1 and 2, that is Aryan Khan and Arbaaz Merchant, travelled together. Why they think that it's a conspiracy, it's something what they are trying to say. Some relevant material facts is what V.V. Singh in his affidavit has said. One, the investigators have found that accused number 1 and 2, Aryan Khan and Arbaaz Merchant, travelled together with a common intent to set on the said cruise. Matlab, that means their intent was very common. They wanted to have drugs on the cruise, is what it means. The material collated during the investigation has primarily revealed that accused number 1, that is Aryan Khan, has role in so far as a illicit procurement and consumption of the contraband is concerned. So they think that Aryan Khan had consumed also and procured also. Whereas they also say that nothing was found on him, and because there was no drug test was conducted on Aryan Khan, so we don't know whether he had actually consumed or not. But they say that their role as far as this is concerned is very clear. Second, the third point which the affidavit mentioned is that it is prima facie, and primarily it is revealed that accused number 1, that is Aryan Khan, used to procure contraband from accused number 2. That means he used to take the contraband from accused number 2, that is Arbaaz Merchant. The sources connected to accused number 2, and the sources connected to accused number 2, that means Arbaaz Merchant was kind of a supplier for Aryan Khan, is what NCB is mentioning, from whose conscious possession, that is shoes, from Arbaaz Merchant's shoes, 6 grams of charas was recovered. Accused number 1 and 2 have been associated in moving contraband with each other, and that is the reason why they should not be released on the bail. These are the three things primarily which they think has been found on them. Another important point, they have said that the respondent submits that on the basis of leads obtained during the investigation of accused number 2, that is Arbaaz Merchant, the respondent, on a follow-up action, one peddler named Shivraj Ramdas Harijan was arrested. So basically, Arbaaz Merchant's interrogation revealed the name of the peddler. And the sixth number point, which is also important, on initial investigation, 8 persons were arrested, and then the rest of the things, that they were taken to the court and they got the custody, etc., etc. But what it clearly means, that the Narcotics Control Bureau in its affidavit clearly had said that Aryan Khan was traveling with Arbaaz Merchant. Arbaaz Merchants, they have recovered 6 grams of ganja, 6 grams of charas from Arbaaz Merchant's shoes. They traveled together to the terminal. That means he was also carrying the contraband, the drugs, along with Arbaaz Merchant, and that is the reason why he was arrested for procuring the drugs illegally. and also for the consumption of it. So this is what basically Narcotics yes. Control Bureau has filed in an affidavit, and now as you can see that Vidya is flashing from inside the court that the hearing is has already started, and additional Solicitor General as expected himself is present for this bail hearing as well.
Well, what Sahil Joshi has just told us, and Sahil, while you read out that affidavit from the Narcotics Control Bureau, it's an exclusive affidavit that Sahil has accessed in telling us how strongly worded that details are. But again, Sahil, all of this, while is very crucial, they may have information with them, it will all have to be eventually proven in court. And to prove a conspiracy of that nature, like you're telling us from the affidavit, would not be the easiest to do, as you're telling us, if the quantity of the narcotics was not of a very high nature.
Well, Pooja, this is really interesting, because right now they don't have to prove anything in the court, because right now the case is at the investigation stage, is what Narcotics Control Bureau had said. When they will file the charge sheet, after that the case will come up for hearing, and during the hearing, you know, all these points may be taken out by the respective lawyers. But till then, the investigating agencies has right to suspect that a particular person yes. is not what he is claiming to be, and that is the reason why they are putting forward this affidavit. One more interesting part of this affidavit, you know, if I may read out the point number 5 in this affidavit, which our correspondent Vidya has actually procured, but very interesting point in this affidavit. V.V. Singh had filed this affidavit, the superintendent of Narcotics Control Bureau. The applicant cannot be considered in isolation, because Aryan Khan's lawyer has been saying that he and Arbaaz does not know anybody else. They do not know Munmun, who is Nupur, who is Ishmet, or the rest of the people who have been arrested in this case. They also do not know the people who have organized this party, because they received the invitation from a person called Nikhil Gaba, whose name even Nawab Malik took in his press conference. His name was taken by Satish Maneshinde also during the bail hearing in the magistrate court, that he received the invitation from Gaba. So he does not know anybody from the people who organize actually this particular party, or the peddlers themselves. Even NCB says that he doesn't know any peddler, because their affidavit says that he was procuring it from Arbaaz, and Arbaaz was procuring it from his sources, and that's how they were getting the drugs. It's what NCB says. So he has nothing to do with the conspiracy. Even if there is a conspiracy, Aryan Khan is nothing to do with the conspiracy. But NCB in the affidavit clearly mentions that one of the applicant, this applicant cannot be considered in isolation. The ingredients of the conspiracy are clear and evident, is what they say. Further, all those persons are in the integral part of the common thread, which cannot be separated or dissected from each other. In such circumstances, in situation, the quantum of recovery from individual accused becomes inconsequential. So basically, when they have realized, the Narcotics Control Bureau, that the quantity recovered from each and every person is a bailable offense, because they were earlier booked in the sections, because the magistrate himself had said during the bail hearing that the sections of the NDPS Act were bailable sections. Even the special public prosecutor of Narcotics Control Bureau also said that in the magistrate court. Even if those are bailable section, why they should not be released is because Narcotics Control Bureau's yes. affidavit says now that they are connected together. Even if they have procured it from different sources, still they are part of a same net, and that is the reason why we cannot look at them in isolation, and that is the reason why they should not be given bail, and the quantity should not matter, is what Narcotics Control Bureau is trying to say. Because as per NDPS Act, the commercial quantity and the intermediate quantity matters while deciding on okay. the bail. But here the Narcotics Control Bureau is trying to convey that the quantity does not matter, because all these accused are connected together by the consumption chain or the supply chain of the narcotic supply.
So what you're telling us, Sahil, is very important, and that is one of the reasons they are saying Aryan Khan should not get bail, because there's a whole chain network that needs to also be investigated further. But because the highlight and all eyes are on the superstar's son, do tell us, when the NCB says we cannot let Aryan Khan get away because he may influence the case. Now, according to the legal team of Aryan Khan, they say we cannot influence. The WhatsApp chats are with them. There was no drugs on him. How is the Narcotics Bureau pushing for that? How do they mean that he can influence the case if he goes out, given his influential status? Over to you, Sahil.
Well, it has always happened that a lot of times the witnesses are influenced. You know, that is what it looks like that the Narcotics Control Bureau is trying to imply. Now, the names of the witnesses are in a press conference given by Narcotics Bureau themselves. They had announced that who are their independent witnesses after Nawab Malik made allegations against two of the witnesses. One of them is an absconder in the Pune police case, and the second one is a BJP worker. Now, this is something where the NCB says that Aryan Khan will use his father's stature, because Aryan Khan is a 22-year-old boy. He is known because Shah Rukh Khan is king of Bollywood. He is a superstar of Bollywood, and that is the reason why he might influence the witnesses, because that is how only the investigation may hamper. So, statements are always made by the investigating agencies, specifically when it comes to influential accused, and most of the time these accused are of a stature where they hold some kind of an authority. It may be a political leader's son, political leader himself, and that is the reason why a lot of times we have seen that the court may also consider these arguments in the court. But this is part of the argument. This is one of the argument. The main argument of Narcotics Control Bureau is about the conspiracy, because 29 is a stringent section.
Yes.
That has been applied for the case. And they say now that everybody arrested in this case are part of the same chain, and they are part of the conspiracy. And that is the reason why they cannot be segregated. Their roles cannot be segregated, irrespective of whatever has been found on them, whether they are found in consumption, whether they are found in nothing, if whether they are found with a minuscule level of narcotic substances on them. It doesn't matter. What matters is that they are part of the same conspiracy.
So, two quick questions here, Sahil. One, the charges against him, if proven, what could be now the punishment that comes with him? Because the bail hearing is now underway just for further investigation. But the case, the charge is also serious of consumption, of procurement. What does that mean if proven for the 22-year-old? And second, when the Narcotics Bureau will push for further custody of Aryan Khan, what will they want to now investigate further? They have already taken the WhatsApp chats. The mobile has now been with the Bureau. What does the NCB now want to imply they will do with the extended custody if they manage to get it? Sahil.
It's very difficult to guess that what kind of punishment would be, because normally we have seen that whenever there is a bust of a rape party is busted, the people who are found with the narcotic substances on them are booked for the peddling charges, the distribution charges, the preparation charges, consumption charges, and dealing in narcotic charges. Rest of the people, like we have seen that in Mumbai, there was a big drug raid happened in Hotel Oakwood near Juhu, and almost around 100 people were nabbed by the Narcotics Control Bureau then. I remember that time all the people were tested for blood and urine, and after that they were let off. The people whose samples came positive for drugs, they were booked for consumption. And normally consumption in NDPS Act is treated as a victim. And most of the times the court asks them if the person has been found for the first time for consuming a drug, then normally the court asks the person to go through a rehabilitation program and report to the court again, which has happened in the case of Fardeen Khan as well. He was found with while buying a narcotic substance in Juhu, and then the case went on, and finally he had to go through the rehabilitation process and inform the court that now he has been rehabilitated. So that is normally the procedure. But here, what we can see now is that Aryan Khan, because he's part of the whole conspiracy racket, as mentioned in this affidavit, it clearly says that respondent further states that submits that a prima facie the investigation conducted clearly discloses offences made out with 8C, Section 20B, 27A, 29, 35 of NDPS Act, which means, in a layman's language, they think that it's clear that prima facie the accused is involved in peddling, distribution, preparation, consumption, dealing, procurement, transportation for the purpose of narcotics, drugs and psychotropic substances. The remand application brings out the prima facie role and involvement of this accused as far as violation of this act are concerned. So this is a there are three accused on which they were supposed to file the affidavit. So they have clubbed all the three accused and filed this affidavit. So this particular section, the comment is basically on some other people. But what it clearly looks like is that NCB wants to make it a bigger case. They don't want to let Aryan Khan off only on the charges of consumption and procurement. Rather than that, they want him to be seen as the accused who was part of the conspiracy as well.
So, Sahil, before I just give you a breather, because the bail plea is currently being heard, Vidya is constantly sending us all the updates. Sahil is also giving us a perspective. But Sahil, here's the fact that we must know, and you would know it the best. These rave parties, these drug parties of youngsters, specifically from high-profile families, it is a reality, isn't it also? And this case is, of course, different. But do tell us that, is it also perhaps these drug parties that are constantly busted is a reality there in Mumbai?
What I can definitely say is that the rave parties are not new for the media. We have seen a lot of rave parties happening even in the past and busted also in the past. And it's not only a high-profile families. We have also seen people from middle-class families, lower middle-class families. Drug is a menace. It's not only in the high-profile families. It's also it's a part of the society. And in the society, we have seen a lot of people consuming ganja, charas, and various narcotic substances. It depends on in which strata of the society you live, and lot of things, such kind of things have been tested even in the world. Why only Mumbai? We have seen it in Goa, we have seen it in Delhi. In fact, the Narcotics Control Bureau's release also say that the drugs found in Mundra port were supposed to be distributed in Noida and NCR region.
Yes.
So, it's a menace which is there in the country, and of course,
And Sahil, as we are speaking, our colleague Vidya, who's tracking all the latest from the court, consistently telling us about what all is being said by the defense counsel and other lawyers as well. I'll just give you a breather for a minute, because while this bail plea hearing is on, Aryan's legal team, and these are top lawyers like Satish Maneshinde, they are maintaining he should be granted bail. No drugs have been recovered on him. He cannot tamper with WhatsApp chats as well. And this, while the NCB is strongly opposing the bail plea currently on in Mumbai. Here's a look now, Aryan's 10-point bail defense.
Aryan Khan faces an extended stint in Mumbai's Arthur Road jail. And the superstar's son has maintained that no drugs were found on him. The big question now is, will Aryan get the bail? Here is Shah Rukh's son's 10 points defense. Defense 1, Aryan Khan in his bail plea has stated that he's completely innocent and has not committed any crime. Aryan claims that he's been falsely implicated in the case. Defense 2, the bail plea states that there has been no recovery of drugs from Aryan. The plea also claims that the NCB does not have any incriminating evidence against him, accusing the Drug Probe Agency of applying stringent provisions of NDPS Act without any proof. Defense 3, Aryan Khan in his bail plea has denied being involved in production, manufacture, sale and transport of any drug. He has even on record denied charges of illicit trafficking and protecting drug offenders. Defense 4, the Narcotics Bureau, had told court that it had access to incriminating WhatsApp chats that pointed to an international drug syndicate. Aryan claimed the chats had nothing to do with drugs, but were in fact about football. Defense 5, seeking bail, Aryan argues that no narcotic drugs were seized from him and the allegations pertains strictly to small quantities. Hence the bar under Section 37 of NDPS Act, making the offence serious and non-bailable, does not apply. Remember, contraventions involving small quantities are punishable with rigorous imprisonment of a term which may extend to 1 year, or a fine which may extend to ₹10,000, or with both. Defence 6, The superstar's son has claimed that the charges would still fall within ambit of consumption of drugs, which attracts a maximum jail term of up to 1 year or with fine or both. Defense 7, Aryan's bail plea claims that recoveries from other accused cannot be held against him and the entire recovery in the case cannot be used against him. Defense 8, Aryan in his bail plea contends that he has no criminal past and was never involved in consumption or use of drugs. Defense 9, during the hearing in court, Aryan had said he had strong roots in the society and is permanent resident of Mumbai. His bail plea claims that there is nothing on record to suggest that he would abuse his liberty. Defense 10. Last but not the least, Aryan in his bail plea argues that not only is he the son of prominent Bollywood actor, but he also holds a bachelor's degree in cinematic arts from the University of Southern California. Aryan says he's a responsible citizen and has impeccable reputation and record. With Vidya in Mumbai, Bureau Report, India Today.
And step-by-step updates are now coming in from the hearing there in Mumbai court. Now the lawyer representing Aryan Khan have said Aryan Khan did not have cash to buy drugs, even if they were available. The lawyer says Aryan did not have substance to sell. The legal team representing Aryan Khan is adding he did not have drugs to consume. He did not have cash to buy those drugs. No connection with other accused that have been taken into custody as well. Saurabh Vakhtania joining me. Saurabh, take us through one by one what the advocate Amit Desai is currently telling to the court with regard to Aryan Khan. They are being very strongly defending him, saying if he didn't have cash, if he didn't consume any drugs, what is the reason that he's still in custody?
Well, Amit Desai is the top lawyer of Mumbai. He's a criminal lawyer and he knows how to get into this. And this is what is right now happening inside the court, Pooja. First of all, he's saying that first three accused were arrested. One is Munmun Damecha, Aryan and Aryan's friend Arbaaz Merchant. Now, what he's saying is they don't know Munmun Damecha, from where all of these three were arrested. There was a particular room from what the NCB is saying, from where all of them were arrested. First of all, he's saying that they don't know Munmun Damecha. Second is saying that there was nothing found from him. There was no cash. There was no drugs found from him. The panchnama also clearly state this, that nothing was found from Aryan Khan. Now, they are saying that there is a big picture. NCB officials saying that this is a huge conspiracy which is going on out in this particular case, and there's a very serious case against Aryan Khan and other, and therefore the bail application should be rejected. Here, what Amit Desai is saying that Aryan Khan is not involved in procuring drugs. Procurement of the drugs and the possession is found from Arbaaz Merchant, and with whom he has nothing to do with it. So he's saying that there is no huge conspiracy, and you cannot hold a particular person for so long inside a custody when nothing is found from that particular person. But NCB here, what Pooja, they will be saying is that when they were living for this particular party, Arbaaz Merchant, Aryan Khan and two others were present in one particular car, and from Bandra West they left to this particular international cruise terminal. Very important part here, Pooja, is also the name of Pratik Gaba has come up in the court again. Pratik Gaba is one of the person in which NCP party's leader Nawab Malik has alleged that they have a particular linkage with BJP, and they too were involved in this particular party. But Pratik Gaba and Rahul Sajdeva and one other person were not arrested. They were let off immediately, after which NCB officials took a press conference just within an hour. They took a press conference saying that nothing was found from them and therefore they were released. So what Amit Desai is also mentioning about Pratik Gaba, that Pratik Gaba is the person who actually invited Aryan Khan to particular drug party. He invited him on the 1st of October. The party happened on the 2nd of October. In the evening of 2nd of October,
yes,
the raid actually took place. in not just Aryan Khan but all others, including Pratik Gaba, Rahul Sajdeva and Amir Furniture Wala, these three names, all of them were taken into the NCB custody.
Yes.
But after few hours, all of them were released.
It is so very important. We are reading one by one. We are reading one by one what the lawyer are saying. The lawyer representing the defense counsel for Aryan Khan is actually said, we appreciate what the NCB is doing, but they cannot just hold on to people. He's also added to the court, to the judges, that other accused may have admitted to consumption. They may have had drugs and bought it for enjoyment. Aryan Khan did nothing like that. So they are saying, we don't know about the other accused and we don't know if they have consumed. They may have had the money. Nothing of that sort was with Shah Rukh Khan's son, Saurabh. Saurabh, if you can hear me, very strong statements coming in from the lawyers who are representing Aryan Khan, and they have said they cannot just hold on to good people, even if they have been busting drug peddlers in other parties. That's what the legal team have said, that you may be, as Narcotics Bureau, doing good work of busting and arresting other drug peddlers, Saurabh. But what precisely are they saying? That others may have taken it, others may have bought with their money for their enjoyment. Aryan Khan did no such thing.
Yes, yes. So Pooja, this is again very interesting argument which is put on by Amit Desai. Now what he's saying is that Aryan Khan and two others, that Arbaaz Merchant and Munmun Damecha, were arrested first, and later on five others were arrested on the next day. What Amit Desai is saying is that the people who actually had drugs with them, who had money with them, why they were arrested a day later? Why were they not arrested earlier? And the person who does not have any drugs available with him, no possession of drug is found with him, no cash is found with him, so why he is arrested first? So he is raising question on the investigation and the arrest and the panchnama done by the NCB official. Remember, Amit Desai has all the panchnama copies and the remand application of the NCB official, and he is reading out one by one. So this is a very interesting piece of argument which is given by the lawyers of Aryan Khan. But remember, Pooja, now it's already past 3:30.
Yes.
They have a very little time left, because once the bail hearing, the arguments of Amit Desai gets over, there will be arguments from the other lawyers as well. Then there will be reply from the NCB officials as well, because remember, today there is not just one investigating officer of NCB official present inside the court, but there is a team of NCB officials who are present. Let me tell you, there are 5 to 6 senior officials along with Samir Vankhede who have reached to the court. They have all the documents available with them, and they are trying to prove and convince the court that this is a huge conspiracy. This is an international drug peddling racket, and all of the accused should not be given
international links
bail
being alleged,
at all, because
by
it will
the Narcotics Control Bureau. Sort of stay on with me, because Amit Desai, the top lawyer representing Aryan Khan, has also said, we don't know who Munmun is, another accused who's been arrested. We don't know what is her case. When they arrested, they just arrested all three of us and produced us together. But we have no idea about this another individual. All we know is Aryan Khan did not have money. He did not buy or sell drugs. He did not have drugs on him. He did not consume it. That is what the lawyer has said. And of course, the Narcotics Bureau will also respond. But while this drug case investigation and legal battle is on, there's a political face-off as well. Apart from that, this between the Narcotics Bureau and the ruling NCP in Maharashtra. Because in the latest attack, NCP chief Sharad Pawar has even raised doubts over the investigating agency. Pawar has said, I quote here, the seizures made by the central agency is far less than the ones done by Mumbai police. There is a scope of doubt here. Unquote. Pawar has clearly hit out, it appears, at the government at the center, stating there is an indication that central agencies are being used for political reasons. NCP is piling allegations against the Narcotics Bureau in the drug case, claiming the Bharatiya Janata Party has a key role to play here. Pawar has lashed out at the Bureau's choice of witnesses and said KP Gosavi is an absconder. The integrity and the character of Gosavi, he says, is doubtful. And if such a person was chosen by senior officials as a witness, it only shows their association, to add that media management is happening of the NCB officials.
जिस तरह से केंद्रीय एजेंसी का इस्तेमाल करके, चाहे वो इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट हो, ईडी हो, सीबीआई हो या और कोई डिपार्टमेंट हो, उसका गलत इस्तेमाल करके नेताओं को डराने की कोशिश की जा रही है। भारतीय जनता पार्टी हो, केंद्र की एजेंसियों का दुरुपयोग जो हो रहा है उसके खिलाफ डट के खड़े रहेंगे और कितनी भी कार्रवाई कर ले, सरकार 2 साल पूरा करने जा रही है, सरकार 5 साल पूरा करेगी। कितना भी डराने का प्रयास हो, हम डगमगाने वाले नहीं है।
Let's go across to Saurav Bhaktania. Saurav, just about 2 more hours to go at 5:30. The court will shut in Mumbai. What precisely is the update now? What has the top lawyer representing Aryan Khan, Amit Desai, is currently telling in the court? Saurav.
So again, the top lawyer Amit Desai is continuously arguing in the way the NCB officials took the action against Aryan Khan. He's still putting on and pressing on the charges that Aryan Khan had no possession of drug. He was not just checked once but twice, and in that way they are saying that there is no linkage. He's also saying that Arbaaz Merchant is one of the accused, who is also a close friend of Aryan Khan, and they are saying that in his statement he has said that Aryan Khan never asked for any drugs. He brought the drugs to the cruise party just for his personal consumption. So this is a very serious arguments which are happening inside the court. But let me tell you today what Sharad Pawar in this case, Pooja, have said are also a very serious allegations against the NCB officials. Remember, KP Gosavi, the man with whom we are finding all the pictures of Aryan Khan. Remember, a bald person who is actually found with Aryan Khan. He is taking selfie with Aryan Khan when he was arrested. And also, he was the person who took Aryan Khan inside the NCB office. Now, who is he? He is KP Gosavi. India Today have tried very hard to trace out KP Gosavi. When we search his name on Truecaller, Pooja, yes, he says that he is a detective by profession. We went to his 2 locations in nearby Thane area. He was not found at his home. The relatives of KP Gosavi told India Today that for the past few years, he has not been in contact. Very important, Pooja, what the NCB party leader Nawab Malik, yes, pointed out, that KP Gosavi gave 2 addresses. In the panchnama which happened in this whole case, 2 addresses were given by KP Gosavi. So there is a sort of negligence or happened from the part of NCB. If there is a one witness, that is the one panchnama done by KP Gosavi, how, yes, can he give 2 addresses in the same case? Now, very interestingly, Pooja, also KP Gosavi is nowhere to be found right now. He is said to be a listed witness in this case. There are total 9 witnesses in this case listed, okay, by the NCB official. KP Gosavi is one of them, but let me tell you, KP Gosavi is nowhere to be found. In fact, a case is filed against KP Gosavi at Pune by the Pune City Police.
That's very interesting.
He is wanted,
yes,
in this case. The Pune Police have already.
So there are different angles and politics also being played here, allegations coming in, but this is a big story. Will top lawyers representing Aryan Khan manage to get a bail for him today, or will it mean next few days of more jail time for Aryan Khan? I'm going to keep tracking all the latest and what's been happening at the Mumbai court.